Salutations, spooks, spirits, and specters, and welcome back to Clannad After Story, where we just found out that a bus was hijacked, and Akio was on that bus, and he got stabbed trying to persuade the criminal to just give up. But in spite of this, he was able to get other people off the bus, except for himself and the driver. And things are looking pretty grim. Start timer. Timer, start! We continued listening to the coverage of the situation with our eyes closed. Then, the next service area. The bus remained at a stop. The person who appears from the opened door is a man of familiar stature. It's the figure of the man holding a cigarette in his mouth, always looking as if he's about to complain about something. However, he's slouching more than normal and leans his weight onto the body of the bus, looking as if he's in pain. I can't quite see his wound because he's wearing a black top, but his jeans are stained with blood, like someone spilled black paint all over them. He faces the police while keeping a distance from them, while the bus driver is still being held hostage inside the bus. He has some kind of exchange with them, but it's too far away, so I can't quite tell what is happening. I wonder if they're not allowed to show his face on TV in this sort of situation. The police carry a megaphone, or at least I think it is, to the bus and throw it toward it. The injured man picks it up slowly. He checks to see whether it's turned on, and then starts shouting something. It isn't quite audible. The man looks satisfied and gets on the bus once again. Descending from the bus in his stead is the bus driver, wearing his uniform. The moment the driver gets down onto the ground, the door closes, and the bus departs. The tires slip as the bus makes a large U-turn, and it leaves the service area behind. Police cars and ambulances immediately follow after it. The only ones left inside are the young man and the injured man. So he's the one driving the bus right now? Just what is this guy trying to do? We all hold our breath and carefully watch over the proceedings. After a few moments, a videotape recording is played back. With the audio corrected, you could now hear what he had been saying. We're going to be setting out on a trip now. I can hear him. We've actually clicked with each other. We've become friends. The boy has someone he wants to see. His grandmother, who raised him when he was little. He says she'd been bedridden ever since 5 years ago. He doesn't know how she's doing right now. But despite that, he's going to come see her. And when he checks to find out how she's doing, I'm going to make sure I'm next to him so he can get through it. All right? You understand. I wonder if that young man is smiling right now, having found such a reassuring friend. He probably is. That guy can get along with anyone, no matter who they are. And he will then make them smile. I knew it. You really are amazing. I couldn't catch up to him, even if I worked at it my entire life. The bus winds its way through the highway at an earth-shattering speed. He's bleeding so much. His consciousness must be fading by now. He's traveling with death. He's probably enjoying himself immensely, though. Every time it looks like he's about to plunge into the median strip, every time the bus swings over so much it looks like it's about to tip over, he's probably laughing out loud. The image goes blurry. Before I know it, tears have formed in my eyes. What's this? I wipe them off, then look at Nagisa and Sanae-san. They're both the same. They are smiling, their eyes filled with tears. I wonder what it is, this feeling we're all having right now. I don't quite understand it. The bus continues running wild on the TV screen. It slowly eases up its velocity. And then, failing to make the next turn, it crashes into the median strip. Now stranded, the bus finally crawls to a stop. It is surrounded by police cars and ambulances. One after another, the police break the windows on the bus, climbing inside. And the announcer reports the conclusion of the incident. We're in the hospital in the neighboring town. The hallway, illuminated by fluorescent lamps, is filled with a heavy atmosphere. The doctor had told Sanae-san he'd done everything he could do, and that the rest would be up to his own life force. The old man, he'd saved many people's lives, and probably also that young man's mind. Still, I look at Sanae-san's profile as she continues to wait with a smile, praying. He was someone who'd always go off somewhere. Someone who always did reckless things. I can't help but feel sorry for her, since she can't do anything but continue on waiting. That's something I've always thought to myself. The old man is a wonderful human being. But I wonder if he's also a wonderful husband. Just what is Sanae-san to him? Is she the same as all those other people? I can't help but feel that way. Is there even a single thing that he can vow for Sanae-san and not someone else? I look away from her. Please, God, don't let this woman feel sad anymore. I pray. The old man kept on sleeping throughout the day. And then, on a morning, 2 days later, when I come back from getting a change of clothes, I bump into Nagisa running across the hallway in a fluster. What's wrong?
Oh, Tomoya-kun!
She says after catching her breath.
Otousan ga inakunatte shimaimashita!
Wait, what does that mean? Are you saying he's woken up?
Hai, tabun, okite sono mama furatto.
I cover my face with my hand. Damn that guy.
まだ傷口だって塞がってないはずです。遠くに行かなければいいんですが。今、お母さんが探してる最中です。智也くんも手伝ってください。
Yeah. I'll go look outside. We split up and start looking for the old man. Sanae-san's probably also looking somewhere else. This has to be unprecedented. Having a seriously wounded patient go missing like that just after they get regained consciousness. He shouldn't even be able to move about all that much due to the pain from his wound. It's so reckless. If he's really alright, Then why doesn't he just show us his smiling face? He really doesn't know just how much we've been longing for that. Is this the same hospital picture? There he is, sitting on a bench, looking down toward the ground. What are you doing here, old man? He looks up at me with a pained expression. Were you trying to play hide and seek or something? You realize we were worried and looking all over for you. You're supposed to be wounded. Seriously, you're so damned reckless.
So da na.
Come on, let's get back.
Ma, mate. Mo chou yasumasero.
How can you be so easygoing? The old man takes out a pack of cigarettes and sticks one of them in his mouth.
今警察と会ってよ。聞き出したんだ。
え？
やっぱあいつのばあさんはもう亡くなってたってよ。
For a moment, I didn't understand what he was talking about. The police. I do remember them coming to see Sanae-san yesterday.So, he grabbed one of those policemen here just now, and asked them what happened? In that case, he must be talking about that boy. I think his grandmother was a person he was supposed to be heading off to go see. But she's gone now. That's so.
でもまあ、本人は取り乱さずにいたそうだ。すでに覚悟はしてたんだろうな。
No, it's obviously because of you.
そうか。だってあいつがブレーキ踏みやがったんだぜ。
Wait, that wasn't you? え？
俺が意識なくす寸前、もういいって言ってさ。
No, I'm telling you, that's also all because of you. But I decided to stop telling him that.
で、警察のやつも面会に来てやってくれって言ったからさ。今から行こうとしたんだが。
わ？
やっぱ無理だ。傷口がまた開いてきたかも。
I guess you lost your cigarette because it's not in your mouth no more. He's holding his hand on the stomach region of his pajamas.Where blood is starting to spread. Old man.
まあいい。このタバコ吸ったらおとなしく今日は戻ってやるよ。
How about we just put that cigarette out and we go back to your room now? He lights the cigarette in his mouth with his lighter. He really, really is an amazing person.There is nobody in the world who could hope to tie this person down.
おっと、また見つかっちまった。
The old man looks behind me. Who does he see? I guess we'll find out in the next video. So thank you all very much for watching. And ciao for now. Ciao for now.